All right, V1 and rotate.
Rotate.
Raise the nose.
It feels so different.
Yeah.
It feels so much different.
It's so solid. Town Dubai is always amazing. Just looks like something out of Star Trek. Little flare and freeze. Just freeze. Let the airplane touch down. Easy.
Oh, wow.
This is different than any traditional flying school. This is an academy that's built for an airline pilots.
We can actually reduce the power.
We take people right at the beginning and we train them all the way from 0 hours to get an integrated ATPL, and then we send them off to there, hopefully to an airline job.
The assessments are not easy. It
no
is
easy.
Difficult, yeah, because we have a lot of exams to do before we can get into the institute.
This is your accommodation
here?
Yeah,
my room.
Wow.
We all knew Emirates has big jets in the fleet, A380 and 777, but today we're gonna fly something smaller, much smaller, a smaller Cirrus 22 in the Emirates fleet.
Right, so we're gonna see, Sam, if you've got what it takes to fly this aeroplane, and let's see if you can land it as well.
I recently got my pilot license. I think this should be a kick. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Complete. Ready to taxi?
Yeah, so you can add a little bit of power for the alternator, so we're now turning right onto Alpha.
Okay. So we go this way now,
that's
Alpha
right.
7.
That's right.
On the 15 November, Roger, taxi Alpha, Alpha 7 holding points, runway 31.
Taxi Alpha, Alpha 7 to runway 31 holding point, also 15 November. The rudder is pretty sensitive, yeah. So Petrus, when did a student actually get into the Cirrus to fly?
Sam, the cadets do 90 odd weeks of ground school, followed by the technical ground school for the Cirrus aircraft, and then they start with the actual aircraft flying. You can say call on the radio, 15 November, ready for departure.
Awaso 15 November, holding short at runway 31, ready for departure. Awaso 15 November, line up in wait, runway 31, vehicle on the runway.
Line number of weight, runway 31. Awaso 15 November. Okay, release power freak.
Bottle lights out, approach clear, runway occupied.
Awaso 15 November, surface wind is calm, runway 31 clear for takeoff.
Runway 31 clear to takeoff, Awaso 15 November.
Takeoff. Make sure you're not on the brakes right now.
That was a 3-4 right Sierra Academy Tower. Good morning. Enter the control zone via Oscar Echo and descend to 1,000 feet.
Speed is
high. Runway 31, QNH 1002.
73, rotate.
Enter the zone via Oscar Echo, 1,000 feet, runway 31, QNH 1002, Oswald 340.
Pause the climb, gear up.
SI 263, enter runway via Alpha 4.
Lower the nose just a little bit.
Just a little bit?
That's
what's our climb speed like?
For
now,
90.
Awaso 15 November. Clear to leave the zone. VFR not above 1,500 feet. QNH 1002.
Yeah, so here's the 311. So that's what she said. We can follow the 311.
Nice. Traffic's not busy today.
So whenever you want, you can take control.
Yeah, my controls now.
All right, you have control.
Jet 906.
Okay. Sam, there's the expo site to the right.
Oh wow, that's the expo site. It's huge.
Huge. Awaso 15 November is a Cirrus SR22 exiting Maktoum CTR Green Communities, routing north towards Montgomery Golf Course.
I was really impressed. It was quite easy, although I used to fly light sport sling and coming on to Cirrus. When I rotate and flying around a little bit manually, and the trims and everything helps out, the flight control principle is the same.
Right, yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Right, Sam, we just crossed Montgomery Golf Course and we're now routing towards Safa Park. And as you can see ahead of the aircraft, the Dubai skyline and the Burj Khalifa.
Oh, I'll get my phone ready. Wow, just saw the Palm Jumeirah. Oh my gosh, the golf course, Dubai Marina. And of course, Burj Al Arab Hotel landmark. It's really look amazing. Dubai look amazing from above. I can only think of today's a little hazy. In the winter, it all cleared up how beautiful it will be. You know what's so exciting is to know this is a uncontrolled airspace above all the buildings here in the city.
Yeah. Right.
This is the best kept secret, now I'm telling you. You can say, what are these little numbers, minus 13, plus 76? You have TCAS on this airplane.
That's correct. We have a traffic avoidance system, and what you're seeing on the MFD is basically traffic, other traffic in our area.
Ah.
Target again, also 15 November, we want one common golf course routing, green community. We request to enter your CTR, cross the extended center line, and route to join downwind at the academy.
Runway 31 clear to land, also 15 November.
And the landing checklist is complete. Okay, so you're a little bit slow there, Sam.
Yeah, Poppy, three white, three red, one white. Adding power. Okay, you are the instructor. Save my landing if I screw up.
Runway 31.
So far, so good.
Preceding traffic is...
Don't take off too much power because we're already a bit low on the speed.
Roger.
You can take the power off towards the end.
Roger, left way is runway 31. It was low on it,
Alex. Okay, start reducing the power. Keep the nose up. Power to idle now. Keep the nose up. Just keep the nose up. There we go.
There you go.
Oh, that's okay.
Slightly ballooned.
No problem. That's good.
Well, thank you so much showing me the Cirrus 22, Petrus. Pleasure.
Yeah, you're welcome, and you did well.
All right, Sam, well done on the flight on the SR22. You passed the test. We'll now send you off to the Phenom, the Grey Phenom 100 multi-engine jet, where you'll fly with John. Let's see what you got.
Good morning, Captain.
Hi.
Good morning,
Sam.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Welcome to Emirates Flight Training Academy.
Before I came, I thought this was just a flight school, but this is huge.
This is different. This is different than any traditional flying school. This is an academy that's built for an airline pilots. So we graduate students to cater Emirates Airline mainly and other airlines when we have capacity. Sam, we aim to be the best academy. We have the best infrastructure, as you're going to see. We have the best industry practice for training. That was His Highness' vision from day one when we established this academy, to be the best in the world.
So I just flew the Cirrus, but it was my first time in that cockpit. The system's all new here. So I'm in this ground class to learn a bit more.
Hi Eddie, how are you?
Hi Sam, yeah, good. How are you doing?
Okay, so something you did earlier, Sam. Let's see if in the classroom you can also get the engine started. Just getting some power to it. The power, we can see what's also happening on some of the other systems. The fuel system is alive now, the engine driven pump is turning, and that's it. This will give you an idea to work your way through the different systems. While you are doing it on one side, you can see what is happening on the other side. So I hope that this gives you a good introduction to the SR22.
Very impressive. I mean, seriously, with this kind of interactive study aid, there's no reason we should complain about ground class, right? We used to thought this was so difficult, but this makes it look much easier.
Welcome, this is our examination room. This is where the selection process is conducted for our cadets. They come here, they put through the selection process, which consists of an exam in maths and physics, which are minimum pass mark of 75%.
I already have a private license from the US. Would I able to join?
Unfortunately, Sam, no. We take people right at the beginning and we train them all the way from 0 hours to get an integrated ATPL, and then we send them off to there, hopefully to an airline job.
$180,000, 2 years, you have to do it back from scratch. Even I have a private license and all that. So why would people still come to EFTA? You must have some sort of advantage, right?
The difference here is we're not just a flight school. We train cadets to become airline pilots. To that end, we have written our manuals to be 777 manual. All the policies, procedures, everything reflects an airline policy and procedure. And additionally, if you pass out of EFTA, Emirates normally requires a first officer to apply for the job of first officer. You need to have a minimum of 2,500 hours of flying experience. However, if you graduate from EFTA, they will put you through the selection process, and if you're successful, they will recruit you to the right seat of a 777 at this point with 250 hours of flying.
So if you like to fly on a 777, this might be a fast track place to come.
Good morning, my name's John. I'm an instructor here at the Emirates Flight Training Academy. This morning we're going to go for a quick flight in the Phantom 100 EV. So the difference between the EV and the original 100 is mainly the G3000 cockpit with the touchscreen displays, and we can set up synthetic vision if we want to. We're going to depart here off of our own runway at Maktoum, and we'll proceed out hopefully around downtown, around the Palm, and be able to see some stuff while we're airborne.
Okay, if you're ready to taxi, do you want to taxi?
Oh yeah, let's.
All right. So it's a computer, it's a brake by wire computer brake system. So what you do is you kind of touch the brakes to wake them up, and then you can use them all you want to. Okay. If you just stab the brakes on, it kind of tends to jerk because the computer takes a second to wake up. Tower Wassel 40 Quebec is on Lima 6 short alpha, ready for the taxi.
Wassel 40 Quebec, taxi left Alpha Alpha 1 hold short runway 13.
Alpha Alpha 1 hold short 1340 Quebec. All right, you have control.
Okay, my controls.
All right, so taxis, what did you fly before?
I flew a light sport, South African May Sling.
Okay.
Line up and wait behind.
Pass message check, weather radar is not required, passengers are advised, we're getting ready to take off. Transponder is already auto, takeoff config has been checked, lights are on, so we're good to go. All right.
Okay.
40 Quebec, line up and wait, runway 13, be ready for immediate.
Line up, wait, runway 13, 40 Quebec, ready for immediate. Okay, you have control.
My controls. Okay, super exciting.
Good day, Wassel 260.
Wassel 40 Quebec, wind 170 degrees, 8 knots, runway 13, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, runway 13, 40 Quebec. Alright, so, power up. Push it all the way to the stop.
Turning final. All the way to the max?
Yeah, right to the stop, you'll feel it.
Approach runway 13,
a bump, there it is, uh-huh. That's good. And release your brakes. Away we go. You have control. Just hold it neutral.
170, I copy.
Let's keep yourself straight. Slide your feet down to the floor. Your heels onto the floor.
Q is down the floor.
Alright, V1 and rotate.
So rotate.
Raise the nose. Up, 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 up. Alright, positive climb. Gear's coming up. And I'm just gonna raise the nose a little bit for you. Okay, right about there.
Can you tell Wassel 18 Whiskey Alpha 2 ready for the bottom?
It feels so different.
Yeah.
It feels so much different.
It's solid.
So much power.
Yeah. Dubai South, good morning, it's Wassel 40 Quebec. We're on downwind at F to 1,500 feet, requesting to possibly transit the zone and exit or enter the MBZ to the north.
Are you guys at the back? Can you hear us?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, Nick. Okay, hopefully,
amazing.
I'm not making you guys sick.
No, you're doing great, sir. You're doing great, enjoy.
All right. Shall we turn the autopilot on?
If you want.
Yeah, please.
All right, autopilot's engaged.
Okay. How many hours usually they work on the Phantom?
It's about 20 missions, so 30 to 40 hours on the Phantom. And then they do a MCC course as well, which is 8 simulator missions of 4 hours each. So it's another 32 hours or so on the sim.
What's MCC stand for?
Multi-crew coordination.
We're very lucky today. It jumped straight from a Cirrus to a Phantom and bypassed all of these 210 hours.
That's right.
Wow, 1,000 feet on a jet sightseeing over.
Yeah, during COVID, when COVID first happened, we were the only planes flying.
Oh, wow.
And the controllers were all bored. So we were the only people in the air. So we were getting direct back and forth right over top of the center of the airport. Right over top of the Burj, because I mean, there's.
So you guys still do some training during COVID?
Yeah, we shut down for the shortest amount of time of the entire company.
Wow. Oh wow, the world is coming. The world islands. Looks like only one island is inhabited.
Caution, obstacle. Caution, obstacle.
Yes, you're correct. The Burj is a big obstacle.
That's right. Yeah, it's amazing to see Dubai so built up now.
Yeah, town Dubai is always amazing. Just looks like something out of Star Trek.
Our highest is 1,500 we can go, right?
I think it's just 2,000.
2,000? Yeah.
Around 2,000 in this area. Out there, it's lower.
In this area is 2, I think.
Yeah, out there is 1,000. In here, we're good up to 2.
So, okay.
out here. You can just ignore the pappies, just look at your touchdown zone and fly into it.
Roger. If you need a flare, just call out or just go around now.
Don't worry, I'll save my life. It's okay.
200. 100.
Probably about here. I'm just gonna come to idle. Your eyes are outside looking up. Little flare and freeze. Just freeze. Let the airplane touch down. Easy.
Oh, wow.
All right.
First landing on a jet.
All right, there we go.
Alpha 40 Quebec, Alpha 5, taxi Alpha, on discretion to the apron.
Alpha 5, Alpha, apron, our discretion, 40 Quebec. We'll break the helm around the corner. All right, I'll take it to park.
Okay, sir.
I have control.
Air control.
There I go, John.
Oh, that was pretty good. I mean, it's the first time in a jet, so we're still alive. The wheels are still on the airplane, so any landing you walk away from, right?
It was good. So I felt like, although it's my first time flying the jets, but the principle I learned is the same.
Yeah.
Although the jets is much faster, you're doing takeoff, rotate 130 knots, you're coming in 110, 120 knots, much faster than the prop I'm used to be on. But it's the next level. Once I build enough hours, I'm sure this is a very easier transition onto the jets.
This is the happening place. It's the canteen here. And my understanding is you get free breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Three meals a day, dessert, coffee, everything here.
Yeah.
And you don't have to pay for it.
No, nothing at all.
Nothing at all. This is quite amazing.
And the point is the food is so good, I'm happy that we don't have to pay for it.
Yeah, I recognize. These are the Emirates Airline catering.
Yeah.
This is the same catering as the lounge in the Emirates Airline.
Now, how did you find out this place?
I came to know through a friend, so he's already here. His name is Tej, so I just got in touch with him and he told me that facility is good, so I just checked it online. And back in India, I mean, there are not so many good flying schools, you know. DGCA is quite a bit slow when it comes to training.
How difficult was the assessment to get into here?
The assessments are not easy. Difficult, yeah, because we have a lot of exams to do before we can get into the institute. But yeah, it is doable. If you can do it, you can do it, yeah.
Outside the canteen, I found a student from Macau, Thomas, here. Yeah. So Thomas, how did you know Emirates Flight Training Academy and how has it been for you?
Well, I started in March. Before the pandemic, I looked online and I found EFTA. Well, to be honest, at first I didn't know about EFTA. From Macau, in Air Macau, we had a cadet program as well. But then I figured out that it was a better chance for me and a better opportunity for me to join EFTA and to better educate myself, I guess, in a way.
You want to fly the 777?
Yeah.
That's why everyone joined here, to fly the 777 Emirates, right?
Hey Sam, come see the accommodation, please.
Yeah, I want to check out the accommodation here.
Please come.
Your accommodation here?
Yeah, this is my room.
Wow. Oh, very good. Wow, this is just like a hotel room, hotel studio.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm impressed.
Yeah.
This is like an Emirates Airline hotel, Emirates University hotel.
Yeah, huh. So we get the housekeeping, so they come twice a week to clean the rooms. They do the bedding, they do the floor, and they clean the restrooms and all that, yeah.
I'll tell you, my house, I don't have people come to clean it. Yeah. You're a luxury here. Yeah, it's housekeeping. What a day. I had so much wonderful experience. I love aviation. Captain, nice to see you again.
Good to see you again.
Well, thank you so much for giving me this experience in your flight training academy. It's world class, and I want a job now at Emirates because I flew the Cirrus, I flew the Phenom, I went through the class, I went through the simulator. Now, can I join Emirates Airline?
Please do.